The test subject is still unconscious. I may have overestimated how much sedative was needed. Clearly, humans are a rather delicate species. Hmm? Oh, I stand corrected. The human has awoken. I will now begin the preliminary assessment. Ahem. Remain calm, human. You have been abducted for a brief, non-invasive study. You'll be returned to your residence after the study has been concluded, with no memories of the experience and no scars, implants, or missing body parts. You've been restrained for your own safety as well as mine. You're probably curious about what I am. Frankly, I couldn't care less about what you're curious about. But I have to obey protocol if I want to conduct studies on lesser species. A waste of time, it's not like you'll remember any of this. Anyway, I'm a member of the Zeran species. We are an advanced race, you'd consider us aliens. We control a few star systems on the other side of the galaxy. Our laws dictate that we cannot interfere with the development of less advanced races, which is why we haven't contacted your planet openly. Of course, that's supposed to be how it is, but humans have become a subject of unusual interest among my people. Well, Zerans tend to find humans beautiful, your primitive lifestyle notwithstanding, to a problematic degree. Quite a few Zerans are leaving to live among humans in secret, and some lawless groups are even abducting humans and bringing them home with them. It's becoming a serious issue. The fact that you haven't learned of our existence is nothing short of a miracle. I'm conducting a study to determine what exactly is behind this phenomenon. My personal hypothesis is that it's all rumor and exaggeration. Your kind has been mythologized, and once a Zeran goes through all the effort to reach Earth, which is no easy feat, they lie to themselves and say that you're all just as wonderful as advertised to justify their trip. I'm going to take some verbal notes during this study, so don't mind my trail of thought. Lay back and relax, or don't. It doesn't matter to me. Anyway, after initial observations, I must confess, there is clearly something to the rumors. The fact that our species looks so much alike is an incredible coincidence. The subject looks like a Zeran, except idealized. As if one of our own had been genetically engineered to perfectly fit conventional beauty standards. I'm uncertain if all humans are this way, or this is an exceptional specimen. More data is needed. Their voice is also very easy on the ears, smooth and melodic. If I had to describe it precisely, I'm uncertain if this is what they truly sound like, or if the universal translator is altering it for some reason. Perhaps it doesn't matter. Most Zerans will use the translator anyway. Of course, it remains to be seen whether humans are truly good companions. That they can be considered attractive by our standards is stretching probability far enough as it is. I personally don't doubt they make for pleasant company. This study will determine how compatible Zerans and humans are with each other, whether long-term compatibility is actually feasible. At the risk of sounding impartial, I think the ideal result of this study would be to find that humans are too primitive and barbaric to make good partners. This discovery could end the wave of unsanctioned visits to Earth. First, I need some basic information about your body. Just because you look nice doesn't mean you have, I don't know, acid sweat or hidden venomous spines or something. I've taken some scans and measurements while you were unconscious, so that's probably not the case, but there are a few things that could be useful to know that requires your cooperation. Keep in mind that the more helpful you are with us, the sooner you can be returned home. Let's start with some deep breaths. Deep breath in. Hold it. Deep breath out. Now again. In. Hold it. And now out. Lung capacity is good. You wouldn't have a problem living in our atmosphere. I can assume that the reverse is also true. Next, I'm going to show you a screen. When you see it change color, tell me what color you see. Yellow. Red, good. And purple, correct. No, that's just a different shade of purple. What's blue? Interesting. Your eyes work differently to ours, then. That could be a concern for Zarin's trying to blend in. If humans ever got suspicious, they could seek out anyone who can't see this blue color. However, there are easier ways to identify Zarin if you know what to look for, unfortunately. This won't be enough to deter the human lovers. No, I'm just going to get a bit closer to... is that you? The smell, I mean? It must be. You smell... Oh my, it's hard to describe. Sweet, I think? It's... undeniably pleasant, frustratingly so. I'll need to remember to run a scan for potential pheromones compatible with Zarin biology. Perhaps this could explain some of the fanatics for your kind. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have inhaled so deeply. I feel a little lightheaded. I'm going to go ahead and say that pheromone theory is likely. It's remarkable that it has an effect on Zarin's. Let's see. I'm curious about some of your facial features here. Are they as pliable as- Oh! That took me by surprise. Your skin is much softer than I would have expected. I think it might have been a mistake to touch it without gloves. But now that I already have... Remarkable. It's so pliable and stretchy. Very unexpected. I would have expected a primitive race to have rough, dry skin. It's very pleasant to the touch. Alright, pardon me while I make some more notes. I must amend my previous hypothesis. There certainly is something to the rumors. If this species does indeed properly represent humans, then their species are pleasing to the eye, to all the senses, really. I haven't taste tested, of course, and don't plan to. Unless you were to find it strictly necessary, of course. This is irritating. Humans can't actually be this enticing. A completely separate species that evolved on a completely different planet shouldn't align with our beauty standards at all, let alone so perfectly. Something must be going on here. Perhaps you're a Zarin descendant? Maybe a group of Zarins in the early days of the space travel secretly settled here? I'll have to investigate. See if you humans stand out on from the native life here or not? Or am I being tricked? What if this is all for some setup? And we're all being fooled by some alien race even more advanced than we are? But why? What would be the point? Maybe my supervisor is right. I do sound unhinged. But I just can't accept this. There can't be a whole planet of bizarrely gorgeous aliens just perfect for us. I mean, how could I compete with that? It might mean she was right to leave. Human, I think that maybe I've let you get caught up in an obsession of mine. There was someone I was in love with. She was just amazing. I was so thrilled when she gave me a chance, but the relationship, it ended up being a lot of work for both of us. When she heard the rumors about humans, well, she left. She said she needed something different, something that felt magical. I wanted to believe that she was chasing some stupid fantasy. And she made a huge mistake, but now I wonder. No. It was definitely a mistake. Look at me. I've only been evaluating you on Tractus alone. How shallow is that? The real issue is compatibility. That's what I need to figure out. The humans can actually make good partners, not just eye candy. I don't have tests prepared for that, though. Plus, certain the rumors were false, I didn't even consider that I might need to investigate further. I'm going to have to figure out some tests to learn if humans can be long-term companions. In the meantime, I suppose you're staying here with me. It's not exactly ideal, for you at least. I confess that I don't mind too much. Well, I can't keep you restricted to the examination table the whole time, can I? You won't attack me if I release you, right? I don't think humans are inherently violent, or there wouldn't be so many Zerans coming here. Alright, well, if you say so. I guess if you do attack me, I can be fairly certain humans aren't suited as partners, at least. Okay, good. Well, I better prepare a holding cell for you. Sorry, poor choice of words. It will be more comfortable than it sounds, I assure you. It's going to be nice having you around. It's been a pretty lonely journey. Having somebody around is going to be refreshing. Especially someone so nice to look at. follow me. I should be able to have the next set of tests ready soon. It's inconvenient, I know, but you're going to be part of some very important research. This should do a lot of good work for both of our races. I look forward to working with you quite a bit.